Hello guys, so in this video I'm going to talk about the feature descriptor. So in the previous video I have shown how SIFT algorithm detects the key features or the feature points. So these points are detected. Now what we need is we need a descriptor for each point. So what is the intuition behind the descriptor? First let's see that. So we saw in our Harris properties of Harris video that if a particular image is rotated, so it is not only important to detect the important features, but it is also important to get a good descriptor. Because say if you can see, if I take this particular feature point over here and put a window on the top of it, I will get a particular image patch like this. And this feature actually corresponds to this feature over here. So when you put the window around it, you will get this kind of an image. So now you can see that these actually are the image of the same object or the same particular location, but their pixel values are very, very different. So if I just try to match it using the pixel values, it will not work. So for that, we not only need to detect the features, but we also need to detect, we also need to give all the features a descriptor. So that descriptor will tell, so that descriptor should be such that it should be same if the objects are the same, and it should be different for the other features. So this feature descriptor should be different from this feature descriptor and the story. So that the match is perfect, so that this particular feature only matches to this feature over here. So now we are going to see the SIFT descriptor. So the basic intuition of the SIFT descriptor is using orientations. So what we are going to do is, we are going to say this is my feature that is detected over here and this is the image patch. So now what we do is we take a window around the feature. So this is my feature and I'm taking a window around the feature. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to calculate the magnitude of edge and the angle of the edge at every pixel in this window. So that is what I'm going to do. So let us see one by one what I'm going to say. So say this is the first pixel that is inside this window. So I took this pixel. Now what I'm going to do is add this pixel. So L of x comma y basically. So L of this L function is nothing but the intensity at this particular point. So L of x plus 1 comma y, which means if this is x, so this is x now. So this becomes x plus 1, the pixel over here, and this becomes x minus 1. So what I'm going to do is this pixel minus this pixel. I will have some value that will come over here, squared plus. Now I'm doing y plus 1. So above pixel minus lower pixel. So that is going to come over here. So that will calculate the edge magnitude at this point, this edge magnitude at this point. Next, I'm going to do tan inverse of this particular thing to get the angle, edge angle at this particular point. So if I use this, I will get roughly something like this. So since this edge is like this, so I can get a angle like this. So I'm going to, so the length of the arrow is shown by the magnitude. So how more the magnitude, the more will be the length of the arrow. And the direction of the arrow shows the direction, that is this. So now you could see that there was a slight edge over here. So because the pixel was on the edge, you get a higher edge magnitude. So similarly, you can also see an edge over here. So for this pixel also, you will get a higher edge magnitude. So now if you talk about this pixel, you can see that there is no edge over here actually. So when you do this kind of a thing, it will give a small magnitude. So you get a small arrow over here. Similarly, over here also you will get a small arrow. So like this, if I compute for each particular pixel in the window, I will get this kind of a map. So here you can see that here the edge location was in this direction. So hence my arrow is like this. So now I'm going to compute the edge location for each point in the pixel, and I can get a map like this. Also, this whatever I have done over here is manually. So this is just to explain you. This is not the real edge map of this particular picture. This is done by me myself. So this is just for explanation purpose. I have not used the algorithm over here. Yes. So coming back. So now you can see that I have the edge. Edge orientations of every pixel in this particular window. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to assign a particular direction, that is a particular orientation for this feature. So this was my actual feature that I was looking at. So the orientation of this feature will obviously will be the maximum number of directions that have come over here. So if suppose I want to assign an orientation for this particular feature, so that is mostly I will say this direction, because there are more numbers of arrows in that direction. So I will say yes, this should belong to this direction. So like this I will assign a particular orientation for each feature that I have detected. So this is very important. So this is what I have detected. So how do we detect that is as follows. So we compute this edge orientation for each pixel in the window and then make its histogram. So how do we make its histogram is as follows. So now these angles may be continuous. They can be any value in between 0 to 360. If I talk in degrees. So if this angle is in degrees, then it can be in any degree between 0 to 360. So first we make bins, or we sort of discretize this value. So we make bins like, so this is in radians, but now I'm talking in degrees. So say 0 to 10. So any angle which is in between 0 to 10 will come over here. Any angle that is in between 10 to 20 will come over here. 20 to 30 will come over here. So like this we'll get 36 bins because there is 0 to 360 values. So like this we get 36 different values, and we see whose so which angle is occurring for most of the times, or which bin is occurring most of the times. So we have a threshold that this is the bin that is say occurring a lot of times. So that is this angle is occurring a lot of times. So you give that particular angle to the feature. So that is the way how we compute the orientation for a particular feature. So I hope this is clear. And why we do this will also get cleared in the next slide. Also, I want to tell you some more things. So over here you can see that there is this circle over here. So this circle is basically a Gaussian weighting function. So we compute the edge directions and the edge magnitude, and then also what we do is we weight this by using a Gaussian window sort of a thing. So what happens is the pixels that are near to the feature have more weight, or they have more dominance, and the pixels that are far away have less dominance. So in reality, this will be a sort of map that we will get. So for pixels that are near to the feature, that makes sense, because these pixels are more important than these pixels that are over here with respect to this feature. So that is what happens. So for this particular feature, I got an orientation which is in this direction. Now, let us first get a little good idea of this orientation. So let's see how can it help. So over here you can see that this was this image patch in one image that we saw. Yeah, so in one image we saw this particular image patch, and then this image was rotated, and we saw that we found this kind of a patch in the rotated version of the image. So we want both of them to match. They are actually the same objects, right? So we want both of them to match. So how can we do that? So we can do that with respect to these orientations you can see over here. So this orientations we computed in the previous slide. So similarly, we can compute orientations for the other image. So this rotated version of the image also we can compute this. So now you can see that these orientations are very, very similar. So similar in the sense, if this this particular feature is in this direction, so you can see that this particular feature in the rotated image is more in this direction. So the orientation of this particular feature that is over here in this image will be in this direction, and the orientation of this image we saw in the previous slide is in this direction. So this is very important that we have found out the orientation of the particular feature. Now what happens is we make that particular orientation at the 0 degree. So now this particular orientation will be the 0 degree for this particular image, and this particular orientation will be 0 degree for this image. So this is very important. We are now going to calculate the other descriptors, or what I'm going to call tell you about in some time, with respect to this what we say orientation, this feature orientation that we computed. So the feature orientation for this image is in this direction as shown. So this is the feature orientation for this image, and similarly we will have a feature orientation for this image which will be in this direction. So that is about feature orientation. Now next, what we are going to do is we are going to have a descriptor for each image, or each feature, sorry, a descriptor for each feature. So we had a feature over here, same we take a window around this particular feature as we did for the orientation assignment. So we take a window around this and we group them into small windows. So basically, if this is a window which is 8x8 window, now we are subdividing the window into 4 parts, which is having 4x4 pixels. Next, what we do, we group all these into one histogram sort of a thing. So this histogram is having 8 values, which is which means 8 different degrees. So the bins over here are 8. So that is 0, then next will be 45, then 90, then 135, then 180, and the story. So like this. So each of this will be approximated to the nearest bin. So if suppose this angle is 15, so it will become 0. So that will this is 135, suppose it is in this direction. So something like that. So if this is 90 and this is 135, so that will become something in so if it is 135, it will become 135. If it is 105, then it will become 90, and the story. So like this, we make bins of 8 over here. So for the descriptor, we make bins of 8 in each particular sub window. So there are 8 values that we will get for this particular sub window, 8 values that we'll get for this sub window, 8 for this, 8 for this. So like this. So I hope this is clear, that we get 8 values or 8 different bins of a particular sub window. So what are this 8 bins? These are the descriptors for each feature. So that is, if I take a descriptor over here, so there is this will come in this direction, then there is this will which will come say in this direction, and the story, and the length of this will all be added. So this plus this plus this, and all the lengths are added, and that will come over here. All this lengths are added and quantized, rounded off to these 0, 45. So I'm telling this as 0. I'll tell you in a bit why I'm telling this as 0. So like this, everything will be quantized and we'll get 8 values for a particular sub window. Next, the 0 degree for this particular thing will be the orientation assigned to that particular feature. So the orientation that we assigned in the previous step, this particular direction, this direction will be the 0 for this particular feature. So since the orientation of this feature is like this, so this becomes 0. So all other angles will be measured relative to this particular orientation. So this becomes 0, this becomes 45, this becomes 90, 135, 180, and the story. So that is what we have. So that is for a region over here. So we have this window over here. So for this sub pixel, we have this. Similarly, for this sub window, we have this particular 8 values. For this window, we have these 8 values. For this, we have this 8 values. So like this, we will get 8 values for every sub window in a particular feature that we have assigned. So for every feature, there will be a window that will go around it. So here I have mentioned an 8x8 window just for explanation, but actually the paper talks about a 16x16 window. So if this is the feature over here, we have a 16x16 window that is placed around it, and every particular window is subdivided like this. So we have 4x4 sub windows in every particular window, and for every sub window we will get 8 values. So we can see over here, so for every feature we have 8 8 8 plus 8 plus 8 plus 8 plus 8, like this. So like this we have 128 values for a particular feature, and these 128 values are the descriptor of that particular feature. So we are just to clarify, so let me go behind. So here we detected each pixel in my previous we detected each feature in my previous video. Now for each feature we will assign an orientation. So say take this feature, so the dominant orientation for this feature will be over here, and then for each feature like this we will have 128 values, and those will be its descriptors. So and those 128 values are nothing but these values that we get over here. So these 128 different values are the values that we that is the descriptor of the particular feature. So I hope this is understood. So there are two main things over here, that one is the orientation. So the orientation you can see is over here for this particular image, and for this image it is here. So in the descriptors for this particular image, this will be zero, this direction will be zero, this will be say 45, this will be 90, and the story. So this is very important. So this makes both of these image more similar, because you can see that over here maximum numbers of direction will be down. Similarly over here also you can see maximum numbers are down, you can see over here. So there are some that are in this direction, there you can see that there are some in this direction. So this angles have that information that both of these are same. So that angles is something that we can match. So that is all about the orientation of a particular shift feature and a descriptor for each feature. So that is what I wanted to say, talk about in this video. So here you can see that this is applied in object detection also. So this image is from the paper itself. So here what they have done is they have trained, that means that they have taken this image and they have removed the shift features and the detected feature points. So they first detected feature points on this particular train image and computed the descriptor for each pixel, each feature. They detected a descriptor and they saved it in a database. Similarly, they did for this frog. Now they took this particular image, test image kind of a thing, and they tried to find these shift. So first they put the shift detectors in this image, so calculating shift detectors on this image, and then they tried to match the descriptors. So they found out that you can see that there is this train that is over here, this particular train is over here. So they could detect this train using the shift algorithm. Also you can see that there is a train over here, so that train also could be detected. So they could detect these feature points, and using these small feature points and descriptors they could detect this train. So you can see that even if the train is behind this particular box, even after that the shift algorithm is able to detect this train. Also you can see over here the orientation is very much different. This is in this orientation and the training was in this orientation. since also after that the Swift algorithm is able to detect this particular train. Also, you can see that the frog is over here. So this frog is over here. It is occluded a lot with this sort of alarm clock, I guess. I don't know what this is. So it is occluded. Even after being occluded, it is detected by the Swift algorithm. So this is one of the most cited papers of computer vision by David Loew. So that is the beauty of this Swift algorithm. So that's all for this video. Thank you so much for watching.